We're counting down now to Rio, a smash by a British band whose lead singer is such a big fan of Michael Bolton's, he chased Michael's car down the street to tell him how great he is. The tale's coming up.
Counting down the hits with Casey Kasem. Casey's Coast to Coast.
Well, now we're up to the song To Love Somebody. It's by a superstar who just might get a cabinet post in the new Clinton administration, Secretary of Voice. As you probably noticed, President-elect Clinton had a lot of trouble with his voice during the recent election campaign. In fact, there were days when he couldn't speak at all. Well, just a week before the election, at the point the polls were really getting close, Clinton held a huge rally in one of the most contested states, New Jersey. And one of the stars who performed at that rally was the raspy voice singer who hit the top 10 with smashes like Soul Provider and How Can We Be Lovers. The singer had spent his whole professional life trying not to burn out his vocal cords. There have even been long periods when he had to stop singing or even speaking to preserve his voice. Well, after he heard Bill Clinton trying to speak at that rally, the singer asked the candidate's aides if he could chat with him. A meeting was arranged, and the singer and would-be president had a man-to-man talk about vocal burnout. The singer told Governor Clinton that he was in serious danger of permanently damaging his voice, and he gave him some personal tips on beverages he himself used, beverages made with hot water, lemon, and honey. The singer also promised to set up a meeting between Clinton and his personal physician, a doctor who specializes in throat problems. The same physician, by the way, who cares for the voice of Michael Jackson. So if there's a cabinet post for Secretary of Voice in the new administration, you can bet Michael Bolton, the singer who gave Bill Clinton all that sage advice, will get it hands down.
Number 46.
Here's the man who won the Grammy this year for Best Male Pop Vocal Performance. This is singer-songwriter Michael Bolton.
Casey's biggest hits.
3 years ago this week, one of the biggest hits in the USA was How Can We Be Lovers by a superstar who's turned his favorite hobby into a way of raising thousands of dollars for the hungry and the homeless. He's Michael Bolton, and Michael's always loved softball. In both high school and college, he was a member of the school teams. And when he played with a band called Blackjack, he and the group put together a softball team to play radio stations. Well, now that he's a solo star, he's created a softball team called Bolton's Bombers. They've got uniforms, cheerleaders, everything. Only instead of just playing for fun, Bolton's Bombers play fundraisers to benefit groups that feed the hungry and house the homeless. Sometimes they'll raise $100,000 at a single game. 3 years ago this week, Michael Bolton hit a different kind of home run, singing one of the biggest hits in the USA.
Casey's Coast to Coast.
Now we're up to the song Completely. It's by a superstar singer who is completely dedicated to his fans. Just recently, Michael Bolton had a lot of problems with a show at the Rosemont Horizon, a big new concert facility near Chicago. Because of technical difficulties, the show started over 2 hours late, and it had to be cut short when the house lights came up before Michael got a chance to come back out and do an encore. It was not a great evening for Michael or his audience. Over the next few days, Michael's record label got a few dozen angry letters and phone calls from fans who thought they'd been shortchanged. And when the executives at the label told Michael and showed him the letters, he was very disturbed. He felt he owed a lot to his fans and he didn't want them to be disappointed. So Michael decided to do something. He grabbed the stack of letters and phone messages, and over the next week, he made sure that each and every fan who had complained received a phone call. A call apologizing for the less-than-perfect performance. And that phone call didn't come from just anyone. It came from Michael Bolton himself. This week, the singer who cares so completely about his fans rises a notch to number 26 on Casey's Top 40.
Casey's Top 40.
I'm David Perry for Casey Kasem. Now we're up to a brand new smash for a man who grew up in the shadow of Yale University, convinced he'd never go there. 2 decades later, he's not only performed there with a full orchestra, he's lecturing there as well. He's Michael Bolton, and when he was a young boy growing up in New Haven, Connecticut, the home of Yale, he admired the great university, but he never dreamed he'd go there. He just wasn't that good of a student. You see, pop music was his love, and the closest he got to Yale was performing in clubs frequented by Yale students. Later in his life, Michael did attend a public college for a while, but he got most of his education in the proverbial school of hard knocks. Well, recently, Michael finally got a chance to go to Yale, not as a student, but as a performer and a lecturer. This April, he did a benefit concert at Yale, a show with the prestigious Orchestra New England. It was a benefit for his nonprofit Michael Bolton Foundation, a performance funded in part by Yale University's Hendon Fellowship Fund. And later this year, Michael will be back at Yale to deliver a lecture on music in the 90s. And while he's there, the singer who grew up in the shadow of that great institution of higher learning will receive an award for his charitable work. This week, Michael's got another award of sorts as he comes into the survey with our highest debut.
AT40 Music News.
More news for Bolton Boosters. Guess who's the latest music star to make the move to movies? Not just as an actor, but as producer and writer. A very ambitious Michael Bolton says he's come up with three film storylines, one of them already in full script form, with a starring role for himself. Michael confidently says, "I'd like to produce, but not direct. And of course, I'd like to write the music. Of course, but when do you sleep?"
Casey's biggest hit.
2 years ago this week, one of the biggest hits in the USA was by Michael Bolton. A singer who says after 25 years of trying to be a star, what he wants now is to be able to be normal. Michael Bolton says that since the late 60s, his whole life has been aimed at making it. But now that he's made it, he's made a 180-degree turnaround. He says that what he misses is being able to go out in public like anyone else. He wants to be able to shop without fans noticing him. He wants to be able to go to the movies. He says his favorite time these days is when he sits down to dinner with his daughters and they talk about their day, just like any other family. 2 years ago this week, this star who's trying to turn away from stardom had one of the biggest hits in the USA.
Casey's biggest hits.
5 years ago this week, one of the biggest hits in the USA was Time, Love, and Tenderness by a star who says he keeps his success in perspective by driving guests through the rough neighborhood he lived in when he was struggling to make it. These days, singer and songwriter Michael Bolton lives on a massive estate in the Connecticut countryside, complete with his own lake and a state-of-the-art recording studio. But just 30 minutes away is the rundown neighborhood in New Haven where Michael was barely holding body and soul together when he was trying to sell his songs. And so when journalists show up to interview him on his estate, Michael makes a point of driving them to his old neighborhood to help them understand just how sweet success tastes to him. Success that he's had with songs like one of the biggest hits in the USA 5 years ago this week. Here's Michael Bolton with Time, Love, and Tenderness.
American Top 20.
Well, now we're up to the song Rio, a smash by a British band whose lead singer is such a big fan of Michael Bolton's, he chased Michael's car down the street to tell him how great he is. Last year, Michael Bolton was having lunch at the fancy Four Seasons Hotel in New York City. After he finished his meal, he went down to the street to get into a waiting limousine. As he climbed in, Michael says he noticed a photographer taking pictures of some musicians. But he didn't pay it much mind. He says his limo was pulling into traffic when all of a sudden one of the musicians was running alongside, knocking on the window. Michael told the driver, "Stop." He rolled down the window and asked what was going on. The man who'd been chasing Michael's limo was out of breath, and it took him a moment to recover. And then he told Michael his name was Simon Laban, and he was with Duran Duran. He told Michael he'd bought all of his records and thought he had one of the great voices of rock. He said he was a big fan. Well, Michael thanked him and said he was a big fan of Simon's as well. And then Simon told Michael he wanted to tell him one more thing. He told Michael, who had recently had his long hair cut short, that his new look was great. And they both agreed that short hair was the way to go. At which point, Michael Bolton headed back into traffic, and Simon Laban headed back to his photo shoot.
Casey's Coast to Coast.